Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "There shall come a time upon my ummah, upon the people who believe in me. They call themselves Muslims and believers. My ummah, when their prayers are not prayed correctly, and when high buildings spread in every place, when people swear in the name of Allah a lot about everything without fulfilling their oath, people curse each other a lot, bribery and adultery prevails, people neglect the hereafter in order to buy the luxuries of this world in exchange for the hereafter." All these hadiths can be found in Sahih Muslim and Bukhari, Tirmidhi, Abu Dawood. These are called the six books of hadith, Numajah and Nisa'i. Ar-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, the Romans will be the largest in number and power and influence. This is a hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You find it in Sahih Muslim, that the Romans in those days used to call them Ar-Rum. Ar-Rum, basically the Europeans of today. Ar-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, before the end of time, you will see this prevailing sign. Trials, tests of hardship, afflictions that are like smoke filling the air, darkness with dark clouds above you, and it will weaken the heart of a person just like his body weakens. In the morning he is a believer, and by the evening he becomes a disbeliever. And in the evening he is a believer, and by the morning he is a disbeliever. So much fitan, confusion, deception, lies. A person in the evening is a believer. By the morning, they went on the internet and it confused everything about their religion to the point where they become atheists. They become something other than their own religion. We live in this time today. Ar-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, you will have, before the end of time, a'immatun mudillun. You will have leaders who will lead you astray. Ar-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a time shall come when a person is given insight in the daytime. So he's very aware. He can tell you so many things about everything of the world. But in the evening, he commits every sin under the sun, takes bribes, become dishonest, etc., etc., etc. People are very good in front of people. But when you are alone in secret, they break every sin under the sun, as though Allah is not watching them. This is hypocrisy, and we live in a world of hypocrisy. He said, the last hour will not come until you find yourself that if you were among 20 young men, more or less, and you check their faces, you look at them all, and you are a believer, you're a good believer, and you looked at, you know, a number of 20 or more or less, and found out that none of them fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then it is time for the hour. And he said, when there will be more evil people, persons than the good ones, to the point when, listen to this, when the believers will hide themselves, too ashamed or too embarrassed or too scared to show themselves that they are believers, just like the way Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, just like the way hypocrites today hide themselves. Hypocrites. Wallahi, as a teacher, I see this among the students all the time, among the youth. At home, they're one thing. In the masjid, Allahu Akbar. But at school, with their friends, when they're out, totally different people, totally different. See, sisters, depends on who they're sitting with. Subhanallah, suddenly their language changes. From subhanallah to talking about other people, to bagging other people, to cursing other people. For Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the believers begin to feel shy to show that they're believers. They're too afraid. They don't want to get up and feel proud of it. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam now said, Al-Mahdi, the awaited Mahdi who will lead the Ummah of Islam. You all know who I'm talking about. There is a man called who is anointed Al-Mahdi. His name is Muhammad son of Abdullah, will come out and he will lead the Muslim Ummah of the world into justice. And he will fight the army of who the Prophet ﷺ called the army of someone called the Dajjal, the deceiver, the liar. And he will fill the Arab world, in other words, the Muslim world, he will fill it with justice just as it was filled with oppression. For Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us, I want you to listen to this beautiful hadith, which is in Bukhari and Muslim. What will you do when Iraq is denied its currency? What will be your state and what will you do when Asham, when its currency is denied? And what will you do when Egypt, its currency will be denied? And you return to where you began in the first place. What does this mean? When Iraq is denied its currency, when a country falls, its currency falls as well, doesn't it? And you no longer deal with its currency. Another currency replaces it. Al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or the narrator of this hadith, the Rasul Azam was asked, how will it fall? And he said, by foreign intervention. Foreign intervention. Al-Ajam. Then, after that, he placed it in sequence. Asham's currency will be denied. So Asham as a nation will fall. Again, another currency will replace soon, and it has to be by a foreign intervention. Then Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, after Asham, he mentioned Misr, Egypt. You think it's over for Egypt right now? According to this hadith, which is in Bukhari and Muslim, something else is coming up. When a currency of a nation falls, it means that the country itself falls and there is an invasion, as Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mentioned over here. It's not happened to Egypt yet, but this is, seems like the sequence that Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is informing us about it. He also said another narration, this hadith by Abu Huraira, the Romans or the non-Muslims who used to exist at the time of Islam, when Islam ruled for more than 1,000 years, there were non-Muslims who lived in the lands of Islam, and they were called Dhummis, meaning the ones who are entrusted to us. They lived in our lands and we gave them the right to live in peace, and they had to pay something in return for our protection of them. But not the Muslims. Muslims pay zakat. They had to pay this thing called jizya, which means that we'll protect you, provide you. Today they say tax, we call it jizya. For the non-Muslims who live among us, only this is a type of agreement. When this, he said, the people who used to do this before, they will no longer do it anymore, meaning they will be overpowering you. And these are the types of people who will invade you. Now these are the facts, and we see it today. What has happened to Iraq is not something that anyone can deny. And what is now happening in Asham is both intervention within and outside. And it is yet to come. Asham, however, is totally different to the rest of the world. It is different to Iraq. It is different to Egypt. It is different to everything. Asham means Lebanon, Syria, parts of Jordan, Palestine. They call it today Israel. I'll call it Israeli territories are in there. Palestine and parts of Turkey. This was Asham. Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, you will also get into a war with the Jews. This type of war that we are in is not like any war you've ever seen before. We are now currently in there. Who are we? Meaning mostly the Arab lands. For Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said in Musnad Ahmad, he said, you will fight the Jews, meaning the Zionists who are occupying Israel now, Palestine is Israel. عَلَى نَهْرٍ فِي الْأُرْدُنِ أَنْتُمْ شَرْقِيُّهُ وَهُمْ غَرْبِيُّهُ. At the cross or the section of a river that is in Jordan, you will be on its east and they will be on its west bank. That is today. The narrator of this hadith says, wallahi, I did not know where Jordan is. In those days, there's no such thing as Jordan. No one knew Jordan. It was always called Sham. Remember? After World War I, it became, or just before that, it became Jordan. The name came out later. Later, hundreds of years after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. How did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam know this? Because he's a messenger of Allah. وَمَا يَنْتِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى. He doesn't speak out of his own desires, except from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, you will fight them, be in battle with them at that river that is in Jordan, which divides you from the west. They'll be on the west, you'll be on the east. And there is a river there that has dried out a few years ago. Subhanallah. He said, there hasn't come an affliction, a trial, greater from the time of Adam. This hadith in Sahih Muslim. From the time of Adam until the end of time, a trial more vicious, more harsher, more deceiving, more upon you than the fitna of Dajjal. When he comes out, it'll be very difficult to stand your ground. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he tells us, the believers will unknow him from three letters on his forehead, kafir or kufr, and the rest of the world will follow him. The weak believers will follow him, and he will not be able to enter Mecca or Medina. And then Isa alayhi salam will destroy him. This will happen in Palestine. And the Mahdi will rise in Asham, in Syria, in Damascus. And there will be a great war between the Romans, Europeans of today, 80 flags against the Muslim nation by itself in Asham. It is going to happen soon. After Egypt loses its currency, Al-Mahdi will come out. So these are only the beginning of what is yet to come, brothers and sisters.
My beloved brothers and sisters, in Islam, the end of the world or the day of judgment is a significant event mentioned in the Quran and Hadith. This day, known as Yawm al-Qiyamah, is described as the final reckoning when every soul will be held accountable for its deeds. Various signs are said to precede it, including both minor and major signs that signify humanity's spiritual decline, moral decay, and natural disturbances as the world reaches its end. Among the minor signs, Muslims believe that people will gradually stray from their faith, honesty will diminish, and knowledge of the faith will be scarce. These are subtle changes in society that reflect a slow shift away from moral principles. Many Muslims observe these signs unfolding in today's world, from increasing dishonesty to materialism and neglect of religious duties, which strengthens their belief that the day of judgment is approaching. The major signs will be undeniable events that mark the final approach according to Islamic teachings. These will include the appearance of the Dajjal, the return of Prophet Isa alayhi salam, and natural events like the rising of the sun from the west. Muslims are encouraged to remain steadfast in their faith, seek forgiveness, and perform good deeds in preparation, believing that only those who hold to their faith will attain salvation when the end finally comes.
Help us build an Islamic studio at www.islamicstudio.org. Link in the description.